Thank you for viewing this tutorial on making your Zoom toolbar stay awake. We will cover the following things in this tutorial: how to wake up your toolbar, how to find the Zoom system settings, and how to change your toolbar settings so that it stays on. First, we will cover waking up your toolbar. When you join a meeting, move your cursor over the pictures to wake up your control bar. In this illustration, we've put a blue box around the toolbar so that you know where it is. When you view your own toolbar, it will not have a blue box around it. Now, finding the Zoom system settings. Once you wake up your toolbar, look for a small arrow to the right of your microphone or video icons. In this illustration, there is a small blue box around that arrow and a larger blue arrow pointing to it. On your screen, those two blue images will not be visible. Once you find the arrow, click on it. Once you click on the arrow, a box will open with a variety of information about your microphone. We want to look at the very bottom of the box where it says audio settings. In this illustration, there's a blue box around that word, those words, and a blue arrow pointing to it. On your screen, those blue images will not exist. Once you click that audio settings information, a new box will open that has lots of choices about how to set up Zoom. For now, we're going to focus on the accessibility tab. In this illustration, it's currently highlighted blue, and there is a blue arrow pointing to it. When you first open your Zoom settings box, the general tab will be open, and that word will be highlighted in blue. Go to accessibility and click on that word. The accessibility screen will open, and that's where we can let Zoom know that we do not want our toolbar to go to sleep. You can find where to click that choice underneath the gray box that's displaying on your screen. Under the words meeting controls, there will be a small box. Once you check it, there will be a white check mark and it will be highlighted blue. It's next to always show meeting controls. Once you see the box turned blue and the white check mark, you know you have designated that you want your meeting controls to always show during a meeting. While you have the settings box open, go ahead and check out some of the other categories. One of the categories that can be lots of fun is virtual background. That's where you can choose a picture to be your background. This is handy if you don't want people to see your messy room that you are attending a virtual class in. If you find that you don't like a setting, you can always return to your settings box and change it. You can choose what you like best and it doesn't affect or change the experience for anyone else. If you still need help, please contact Spark by emailing spark@umkc.edu.